Mr. Metzger?
Yes?
This is for you.
Hello, this is Metz.
Good morning, Mr. Metzger. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, involves jumping the fountains at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Seriously?
Oh, no. Not the fountains again. Sal, are you hearing this?
I'm hearing it. Jamie, you should get over here. This is not good.
I don't think that's what he had in mind when he jumped the fountains at Caesar's.
You may select the motorcycle of your choice, as long as it's a 250 two-stroke.
Cam, he is not really gonna try this, is he?
He's crazy, but he's definitely not that crazy.
And as always, should any member of your posse be caught or killed, the secretary will disavow all knowledge of your actions. Oh, and Mr. Metzger, did I mention, in your case, you'll be doing a backflip.
Accomplished.
Motorcycle jump. Imagine launching 112 feet into the air, over the famous fountains, throwing a backflip, and you have the impossible jump presented by Mission Impossible 3. Hi everyone, welcome to Las Vegas. Huge crowds have gathered. I'm Susie Culver. What better way to celebrate 40 years of Caesar's Palace history than with a high-risk feat that promises to take your breath away? You don't have to be an X Games fan to appreciate the enormity of what we're about to witness. A world record try with a Guinness World Record representative on hand for longest backflip attempted by the most influential rider in freestyle motocross. Mike Metzger has been riding motorcycles for 25 years. He's helped drive the progression of the sport, and tonight, perhaps his most daring maneuver to date, and it'll be seen on ESPN worldwide. Along for the ride tonight is Cameron Steele, who checks in from the takeoff ramp. Cam, what makes this jump so tough?
Well, Susie, what makes it so tough isn't that they had to find a platform to build in here, two-thirds the length of a football field, or even elevate the 10-foot takeoff ramp 10 feet above where Evel Knievel actually impacted in his crash. There is no run-by. There is no test run. You can't go by it. It's a drop-off or the fountains. The only safe way to get over this jump is to go 102 feet to the safety deck, but it's really not safe until you get to 112 feet, the first safety spot, and that's where Jamie Little, the third member of our announce team, is standing by on the landing ramp.
Well, Cameron Steele, once he leaves you, he will soar 112 feet above the ground and across to where we're standing on this landing deck. Mind you, it's going to be upside down. Now, this landing deck is 24 feet wide and 24 feet high. If all goes as planned, he wants to land somewhere here in the middle, about the 120-foot mark. Now, we check in with Sal Masekela.
Well, Jamie, we can't wait for that. And you know, tonight's impossible jump is a pre-party of sorts for another impossible. Mission Impossible 3 opens tomorrow night, and you know it's gonna be stunt heavy. We'll be checking in with director J.J. Abrams, Tom Cruise, Kerry Russell, and the rest of the cast in a little bit. But you know, Mission Impossible and motorcycles, no strangers. Who could forget this classic stunt in Mission Impossible 2 when Tom Cruise's character, Ethan Hunt, and his nemesis, Sean Ambrose, face off in an old Western medieval crazy joust. They're coming at each other full speed on the bikes. What's gonna happen? What are they gonna do? They bail and take each other out over a cliff. And Susie, unfortunately, the Godfather will not have another motorcycle coming at him in the opposite direction tonight.
Maybe that's next year. And to your point, groundbreaking stunts, all part of the theme. We're hoping tonight's jump just whets your appetite for more. The Tom Cruise action thriller, Mission Impossible 3, opens everywhere tomorrow.
Go cameras, we're on our
way. Hey, marker.
And action.
This film is going to give the audience that mission ride. There's more stunts and bigger sequences, more than I've ever done in any movie ever.
All the things that happened in this movie, Tom did every single one of those things, like, you know, having trucks drive over him or sliding down things, for the big fight sequences, sort of jumping off the building.
That was fun.
Because Tom does so much of his own stunt work, it's something to respect. He obviously said, if I'm going to do these films, I'm going to do them. Now that I've been shooting this film, you see that it helps the film.
When we return, we'll study the evolution of the backflip. Don't go away.
A clear picture is critical on many levels. One of the misconceptions about action sports athletes is that they are a crazy bunch of kids. Mike Metzger is a 30-year-old family man, married, father of two. His life has been devoted to the sport, and what he's doing tonight represents the next level of progression in freestyle motocross. And throughout the night, we'll be able to check in with Mike. He's back at his trailer. And Mike, first, what motivated you to try this jump?
Well, the progression of freestyle motocross and, you know, the love of jumping bikes and just being a part of the industry. You know, I'm just really fortunate that ESPN came to me to make it happen. So, pretty excited. You know, it's going to be a Guinness record attempt right now, and I'm looking forward to getting it over with so we can all go hang out at the monster party across the road.
You know, a lot of this is tied back to Evel Knievel, and he was considered a stuntman. How do you compare what you do to that?
Yeah, I definitely don't look at myself as a stuntman. I look at what I do as a professional freestyle motocross athlete. And, you know, the difference between a stuntman, someone like Evel Knievel, who goes out there and puts his ramps apart and says, I'm going to go out there and try this. I don't do that. I don't try anything. I go out there and I get it done. So that's the difference. I take baby steps to get to the big picture. The big picture right now is a 110 feet ramp to the top of the tranny where it rolls. And I'm looking to go anywhere between 110 and 130. So, you know, 120 is the mark, give or take. But, you know, it's going to be exciting. I'm looking forward to it.
And it's going to be a world record. Mike, we'll check back with you in a bit. Right now, for more perspective on the level of difficulty of the backflip, let's go back to Sal.
Thank you, Susie. You know, the backflip is never a sure thing for these guys. And 6 years ago, the backflip was really the stuff of urban legend. No one really thought that it could be done. Well, here we are 6 years later. We're at Caesar's Palace. The question is, how did we get here?
You gotta be stupid to try a backflip. Ask Carrie Hart. Ask Caleb. It's ridiculous. Really no reason to even be attempting something like that except for just the guts and glory of it all. Risk, the chance of walking, the chance of actually living. That's part of our sport, I'd say. 220 pounds of heavy equipment coming down on top of you ain't the funnest thing, so watch your back. Backflips.
Houston, we have a problem. Travis Pastrana just did a backflip.
A lot of us talked about doing the backflip, and Kerry set the fire under everyone. And
wow, that was just amazing.
For me to be able to do a backflip for thousands of people, God bless, dude, because you know, people on the ground could only imagine what the heck does that feel like.
Anyone that says they're not scared doing the backflip is lying. I know I'm scared every time.
Is it gonna make it?
I gotta have it.
No footage backflip for Metzger.
Oh, Deegan! He landed a 360! Oh my gosh!
announcing an exciting
back-to-back backflips, the biggest thing to ever happen in freestyle motocross.
I'm just a professional athlete that jumps bikes. I've always wanted to make a living, ride my motorcycle, and then all of a sudden started making money. Havasu was the first time I won a jump contest and I made 10 grand. Started racing like right when I was almost 6 years old. I've been riding bikes for over 20 years. Motorcycles is my livelihood, just enjoying myself and soaring through the air. My job on the daily basis is risking my life. My kids, I don't think, are old enough to really know what dad does. And the lifestyle we live is dangerous. The consequences are that much heavier. The bottom has a rocky reputation. I broke my back 3 times. I broke both my femurs, did a backflip, over-rotated, ripped me wide open. Basically shattered the whole right section of my foot. I know as soon as I can walk or use my arm from breaking it, or you know, I know it's gonna call me back.
You want the truth? You can't handle the truth. Confessor, there's no place you can
hide. You can't hide from the eyes. But it's the sport and the love that I have for the whole package. Don't you even try. I'm a believer. God takes care of everything. Confessor, you can't tell a lie. You cannot tell a lie. Riding my bike is just an extension of who I am. It's in the blood. It's my lifestyle. Strip you down to size. Naked as the day that you will. And that every time I get on my bike that I'm taking the risk of dying. Maybe wild, maybe a bit insane. I really enjoy just hearing people comment on what we do. Freestyle motocross is never stale. There's never a dull moment. I'm a lucky human being to actually be making a living jumping bikes.
A stage like this is the ultimate dream for a man who at age 3 was jumping over things in his driveway on his big wheel. And even though this is being broadcast worldwide, the audience that means the most to Mets is right here. The Supercross community, Metzger's roots are in racing, and the finals also in Las Vegas this weekend. So crowds here are huge. Metzger, always the entertainer. And with the launch of Mission Impossible 3 tomorrow, this is the real life action thriller.
When we come back, Mike Metzger attempts the impossible jump. Don't go away.
Few minutes before the jump. But of course, this is still daring, Sal. What concerns you most right now?
Well, my heart rate has gone up at least 20 or 30 beats since we started the show. I'm definitely concerned. But, you know, really just the case of nerves, the size of this stage, the amount of people, and the history that it is following Mike Metzger, it's got me a little freaked out.
What's he doing right now?
Right now he's just siding the jump. Looks like he's got a little Evel Knievel style cape and all, which I'm wondering if he'll jump with that, because when you do the backflip, you gotta turn your head all the way back to sight it. I don't know if the cape will get in the way.
Maybe that's just a little bit of dramatics, like, you know, big boxing.
Yeah, I think the cape is coming off for sure. I'm just astounded at the amount of people that are here. And my favorite thing of the whole package is the camouflage tires. That is as hot as it gets.
Guys, here we go. This could be it, the impossible jump.
Yeah.
Mission accomplished. Mike Metzger has set a world record for longest backflip jump.
We're going to Disneyland. Are we going to Disneyland?
Yeah. As well.
Woo!
Ryan, do they keep going or five still?
We got the
dance buddies.
Yeah.
That was a big one too.
Hold on,
thank you, everyone.
When do you want the
thanks, match? Everyone! I know it! That was at least 120. Give me a hug. I'm gonna go up there and check.
He did it. There no practice. He did it. First look, try.
I speculated that he might come out for a straight jump first, and he came right out and nailed the backflip. Look at the execution. You see him looking around, siding it a little off axis maybe, but oh no, it was perfect. Mike Metzger was perfect, and I'm not going to fathom a guess, but he definitely cleared more than the distance needed to get to the start of the roll of the ramp. He is midway down, it looks like.
Did you see the way he comes down on that back wheel cam? How hard is it for him right there?
It looks like he actually grabbed the rear brake because he was over-rotating a little bit possible. Mike is just the ultimate pro, the motorcycle just expert. He dialed it in so perfectly where other people would melt away in the Vegas heat. Metzger just excels.
The emotion of his parents, Ted and Sharon, as they watch, and he just nails it.
Unbelievable.
Well, let's hear from the man himself,
Mike.
The world record holder, Mike Metzger, is with Jamie Little.
Well, Susie, it is official, 125 feet.
Yeah. Way to go, Mike.
Celebrating. Welcome, Mike. Tell us what accomplishing this mission, it's been building up and building up. What does it mean to Mike Metzger?
Well, it's just the start of going bigger for freestyle motocross, and it's something I've wanted to do forever, is push the sport. And there's not a better place to do it than right here. We're where everyone pushes the limits in Las Vegas.
Mike, we're gonna show another re-air here. Take us through start to finish. First of all, what was going through your mind going down and off the takeoff ramp?
What was going through my mind? Well, I like to turn my mind off. I like to look around at all the people. I like to look and see what everyone else is thinking. I don't like to think what I'm thinking because I know what I got to do. So right there, midair, I knew that I was going to go a little long. I gassed it a bit more than I did on previous practice runs. So I pulled up a little too to over-rotate, make sure I was coming down the landing as far as I could. I knew my back wheel was going to get the Guinness World Record, and tried to stretch it. So 125, I think, is right around where I landed. So we'll see. We'll have to talk to the Guinness boy.
All right, Mike, what does this mean for freestyle motocross?
Pretty much it means everyone in freestyle's got to go a bit bigger now. So we're stepping it up. Huge third gear backflips. You better make sure you go and watch me and all my boys hanging out at X Games this year in LA. That's what it's about. Pushing the limits.
Congratulations, Mike Metzger, 125 feet. Susie,
world record holder. Sal, put this in perspective, because we've seen backflips before, but not like this.
Well, for one thing, the backflip is never a sure thing. Every time that these guys, you know, leave the jump, it's never a sure thing. There's Mike right now getting his official world record commendation. But for action sports as a whole and for the sport, it makes sense that it's the godfather, the guy who's pushed this thing from the beginning, that takes it to the next level.
It definitely does. I mean, he started the sport of freestyle motocross, and he takes it to another level. And the execution's so perfect. I mean, we were all, everybody here was nervous. I was nervous. You guys were nervous. I guarantee
Mike
goosebumps.
I literally had goosebumps.
To be a little bit nervous, but he nailed it perfectly, and it just sets the bar another level up. And I can only imagine that maybe 30 years from now, someone might try to duplicate that.
Truly amazing night. The progression continues. A new bar has been set for freestyle motocross, 125 feet with a backflip. For Cameron Steele, Sal Masekela, Jamie Little, the godfather, Mike Metzger, and all the people that made the impossible jump possible, I'm Susie Culver. See you this August in Los Angeles at X Games 12. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.